In this video,
I want to know what you're doing.
Excuse me. In this video, you're going to see how to set up your frame to accommodate an M365 rear motor. First, you need to drill out your dropouts so that the axle can slide in. Both sides.
The chain in those handcuffs is high tensile steel.
You're also going to notch it using your angle grinder, so you can go ahead and measure that axle and mark it onto some blue tape using a razor blade. Go ahead and cut that out with your angle grinder.
It'll take you 10 minutes to hack through it with this.
Clean up those edges so you don't cut yourself during assembly. Repeat the process. Measure what size you're going to notch your rear dropouts to accommodate the hub motor. Mark it with your X-Acto blade. Cut it out with your angle grinder.
You can hack through your ankle in 5 minutes.
Don't forget to clean up those edges. So the motor slides in, but there's too much room in there. It needs to be bent in. So put about 200 pounds of force onto each side. Bend them in equally. You don't want to bend one in all the way and not bend the other one in equally as much. You've got to make it even. But look, you can look forward to burning out with your M365. That's an all-wheel drive one that I built like a year or two ago. Don't go too far on this. Wheel slides in fine. Now you get to choose what you're going to do with your rear fender. You should install an ES2 foot brake. As you can see in this scooter, I just installed the stock rear fender, so it's not really that safe only having an e-brake. This here is your foot brake on my all-wheel drive that I've been off-roading with for a long period of time. Works super awesome. Like, comment, subscribe, ask me questions. I've made a few all-wheel drive M365s. Catch you later, people.